These weeks leading up to our move into our new facility, moving moments. You can see here from our screen that we are moving indeed, and we have only a few weeks left here. And so what's our count here at this point? Here we are, I believe, after this Sunday, we have the slide with our numbers, at 4 Sundays to go, okay, friends? So we're getting down there. It's getting very, very close, so excited. And as I mentioned last week, we were introducing a short part in our services as we prepare for moving that we were calling indeed moving moments. Moving moments are some topics that came to our minds where we thought, you know what, this doesn't fit in a sermon, it doesn't fit in our announcement time. These are some things that we want to talk about so that as we move into this new facility that God is giving us, we can actually do this well. Now, some of these are more abstract and conceptual. So last week we talked about the nature of change and what does that feel like for a church to be in one place for 14 years and then all of a sudden move into a new space. There's a whole lot of change involved in that, and that feels differently in different moments. And so if you missed that moving moment, we posted it on our Facebook group page, and so you can look that up there. I hope that you might find it. This week, I wanted to hit something very practical as our moving moment, and I want to talk about parking. We want to talk about parking at our new facility. So on the morning that you arrive, in a number of weeks, we will be ready. I hope you've driven by and you have seen our freshly sealed and freshly painted parking lot. It's very attractive. You can see it here behind me. Look at that. That's gorgeous. There we go. So, parking, and I hope that even that and seeing those steps come together have been exciting for you. And I wanted to mention a few things as it relates to our parking. Most things obviously are going to be self-explanatory, right? You're going to come in, you're going to find two yellow lines, and you're going to put your car in between those two yellow lines, okay? If you have not mastered that basic step, there's not a lot that I can do to help that, but there are a couple of other things that I wanted to mention to you that you can have and share together for helpful information. First off, as you come to the parking lot, particularly at the one peak time on a Sunday morning, we've developed a real simple one-way system in the parking lot wherein the lane that's closest to the front door is northbound traffic, and then the other side of the parking lot is the southbound lane. And so most of the week, it's not going to be a big worry, but it will help a little bit on Sunday mornings if you just simply follow the yellow arrows, Dorothy, all right? We've known also from the beginning that our basic parking lot, the one that we have a picture for here, actually does not have as many spots as we will need on a given Sunday, as I mentioned during the peak time. So that's okay, because near our facility is all of the public parking that we're going to need. And we did a study on this so that we would know if this facility was going to work for us. But let me show you here something by way of a map. And I think we showed this to you a long time ago, but just to encourage you about how much parking we actually have. As I mentioned, our one lot right in here, that's all the parking that's the most direct. But friends, if you park anywhere within this blue circle or this lighter hued circle here, all of that is closer to the front door of the building than is the closest spot in the high school parking lot, all right? So you're already off on a good foot, okay? And then the green loop here, and you've probably been parking that distance in the high school parking lot for 14 years, though it may feel just a little bit different as you come. Now, someone mentioned to me this morning, oh, it's gonna be so nice there by the new building because the wind is gonna be way different and it's gonna be blocked. And we thought, man, for the ladies and good hair days and all this kind of stuff, praise the Lord, he provides, this is good stuff. So, being that we have this facility and these are some of our parking matters to share, I wanted to just ask that you would consider a couple different aspects of our parking there. The first is, as you arrive on a Sunday morning, if you are someone that has a healthy constitution, good set of legs, we are thinking, hey, consider parking in a little bit of the outer loop there, in one of the public spots, And maybe we'll try to leave the parking right by the front door for those of us who may need a shorter walk or visitors and guests for the day. So we're not going to monitor that and give tickets or anything, but just think on that as a ministry. You might consider, because of our location in town, biking or walking to church. I actually think that would be a tremendous witness in our community if there were a whole bunch of people, maybe even carrying their Bibles, walking to church and people going, where in the world are they going? They're going to hear from Jesus. So you might consider that. We hope that on a Sunday morning that you might also consider parking just north of Corning. So, you know, as you look at our map here, our building sits just north of Corning. And Corning is obviously kind of the main thoroughfare through town, so that's going to be the most traffic. I still assume that on Sunday morning that's not going to be all that busy, but there is plenty of parking. Laser pointer is dying. I'm so sad. Except it just worked in my eye. Somewhere in there. You know what? You know where Corning is. Park north of Corning. I just learned this week that there is a very attractive lot to the southeast corner that we're all going to want to park at, but we were asked not to park there, and we want to be good neighbors. That is the other thing I'm asking that you might consider. Would you help us be good neighbors to our community? And in those first few weeks, as we kind of learn our rhythms, let's not park in people's lawns and all of the above. And if you happen to bump into anybody who is in the community, and if they were at all frustrated by our new movements, would you tell them, oh, please let us know? Would you let us know if you'd love to be in touch with them and find out how we can do this well? As we mentioned, we want to be good neighbors to them. And then finally, with so much activity, it's going to be a real blessed beehive there on a Sunday morning. They're coming and going, there's different roads. Would you also just help us consider safety, especially for the little ones? There's not these huge lawns around for them to run, and so we're just wanting as a congregation keep our traffic flow slow, be watching. So much better for us to move slowly than to have any kind of accidents or injuries of any kind of nature. So what a gift God's given to us in this new facility. It's exciting. We're grateful. We are just expectant for what God's going to do there. But practicalities, and so that is today's moving moment. There you have it. Now.